Okay, so I'm going to send these guys back to Windcaster, along with my cavalry here that I want to retrain. So let's get our retraining underway there and there. And I actually can't recruit any of these units. So we're going to actually just disband the Axemen and recruit some Spearmen instead. And I should really start thinking about building up some military buildings after these improved farms. Alright, well, let's continue fighting. Speaking of smaller battles, let's deal with this one here. Now I do have cavalry on my side, so I should be okay as long as they don't get shot up. So I will see you at the, well, actually I'll do the attack, and yes, I have 9-to-5 ratio. Actually, that last battle left a little bad taste in my mouth, because most people want to see large, more epic battles. Well, you know what? Screw it. I'll fight this. I'm afraid if I auto-resolve it, people will just be like, no, you don't think you could have won, and so you're letting the computer do it for you. I guess that might be true, so I will fight it on the battle map. Alright, for this, since they do have mercenary crossbowmen, what I'm going to do is actually have my spearmen in these long, thin, spread-out ranks to approach. Once they get closer, I will then tighten them up, have them attack, and if my cavalry, my bodyguard knights, have an opportunity to strike at those mercenary crossbowmen, they will. And they're all the heck the way over there. Interesting. In fact, I might be able to get some slightly higher ground, so let's redeploy over here, and I'll get back to you. Oh, well, as I'm moving, they're sending out their mercenaries right here, their crossbowmen, so this will be the opportunity I'm looking for. I'm going to try and actually come at them right now. Forget getting a higher advantage. They're really far away from their spearmen, so this will be the advantage I'm looking for. Hopefully I'll be able to get a charge in before they fire, but it doesn't look like it. Yeah, no, they're going to hit some of my cavalry. Oh no, they shot at my spearmen. Perfect. Perfect! Okay, well now that they're being chased, I don't need these guys in tight formation or spread out. So let's run them up this way. Oh, they were able to skirmish to their back lines, okay? Then we will go back. Ooh, luckily those spearmen, those are spearmen and not ferdmen, because they're just rebel Norse. Okay, let's charge there. Where the heck are my other guys? There they are. Okay, let's take a quick little charge. Yeah, at their crossbowmen. There we go. Spearmen versus spearmen. Cavalry versus bows. And these guys should be able to hit them in the flank pretty soon. How are these guys holding out? Defeated is a distinct possibility. They just have to hold on for a little bit longer. In fact, I'm going to put them... Oh, they can't go on guard mode. That's weird. Oh, well. Side charge time. This should tip things into our favor. There we go. Their crossbowmen have routed. So let's just get my cavalry a little bit further back. Now we can get ready for a charge. I'm going to wait for them to get into a complete place until this actually shows that they've stopped. The balances are relatively even matched. There we go, they stopped. I'm going to single right click and then press the run key, which is R, and see if that actually affects the charge whatsoever. Let's see here. Yeah, that seemed to have been significant, and they broke. Fantastic. Oh, and there's the stupid mercenaries just stopped breaking. Oh well, we'll just send the cavalry over there to deal with them. So there we go, this is a lot more short and sweet compared to the last battle, and that's because I had absolutely no cavalry, and it's hard to chase down guys and flank when you don't have a highly mobile unit, or at least when both sides have units of equal mobility. So off they go. Soon I will get a victory sign, probably before they even get touched. Well, maybe that's not true. There we go. I'll just end the battle because it was against brigands. And that was a clear victory again. 224 kills, 51 losses. Hugh Devranche has a plus one command star now. That's good. So I'm going to send him back down to Governor Rouen. And these guys will head back up here. I'll merge them real quick, and they'll get ready to be retrained in Boulogne. All right, so we have a few more military matters. Well, let's deal with these guys first. Okay, these armored axemen are definitely going into Ludenvik to be retrained. Now, honestly, I do not need this many light units, so I'm actually going to disband these axemen and whatnot, and that will actually give me a population boost. So when I retrain, retrain these guys, I won't actually lose nearly as much population. I'll still be floating over 1,000. And in fact, I'm going to want to... Okay, I don't have nearly as many archers as I thought I would, so that's good. So I'll keep these guys. And maybe can I retrain them too? No, I can't. Okay, that's fine though. They can just stick in there. Now what I'm going to do, actually, is start retraining some of my spearmen into armored spearmen. Oddly enough, they're actually cheaper because there's 40 less of them. But the stats are... Well, actually, their attack isn't as good, but their defense is much, much better. So, I'm going to take them. So, I'm actually going to disband this one unit of spearmen so I can recruit a unit of armored spearmen. And once again, the population will stay the same. In fact, increase a little bit. And my clerics and whatnot, they can just hang out here because there's not going to be any room in here. And, excellent. So we're getting up some good defensive forces, because while this offensive little branch here does its thing, I don't want to be, you know, surprised by these guys. Alright, so let's, speaking of my larger force up here, let's attack whatever the heck this place is. Now I see peasants and a bunch of light furred. I was tempted to not show this, simply because you guys seen a lot of, you guys seen a lot of small, you know, village battles, but I am known for not auto-resolving all that much, so you know what? Let's show it, and whatever. I can always just edit out some stuff. Ooh, wow. William has a gold chevron now. Amazing. Good stuff. Good stuff. So yeah, let's attack it and assault it. The odds are huge in my favor, and I will see you back at the battle. Alright, so here's my setup. I actually set things up in two wings. I'm going to have my archers do most of the work, but if they come out and try to engage, I'm going to fix them with spearmen and then charge them with cavalry. Very simple, very basic. And same thing with this wing. They're on pretty equal parts with, for the most part, equal bits. This has a little less infantry in it because I'm assuming that they're going to send most of their guys this way, but we'll find out. So let's start the battle, and really, really nice is that they actually have some units out here already. So let's engage the light furred right here. There we go. Let's see how that works out. And do we have anyone hanging out back here yet? No. So we're going to simply advance. And just advance up to here. Come on. There we go. Very good. And while we see how these guys do. Oh, they're coming for me. Oh, no. No, they're not. They've thought otherwise. Oh, maybe not. Okay, you know what? Yeah. Let's break them while they're outside the town square. We're going to give them a charge. There we go. Okay, we're going to have my archers stop firing. That was a frontal charge. It wasn't great, but actually didn't lose anybody. That's fantastic. And there goes one whole unit of Ferdmen. Fantastic. And in fact, I'm going to have them continue to pursue and go for these peasants and see how well they do. In the meantime, let's bring up the rest of my archers. And my infantry. Alright, how are we doing over here? No resistance so far. And they have... Oh my goodness, look how many units they have clumped up in there. Pitiful! Pitiful, I say. Okay, so we're going to set up my archers right around here with my infantry. Oh, there goes their peasants. I think. Yep. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay, don't get too close, my horsemen. Let's set you guys up around here for a change of pace. Anywho, as I was saying, I'm setting up my archers there, and my infantry will go... one will go behind, actually. Let's see here. What should I do? I'll have the armored guys go behind, and then these guys on each wing. Oh, actually, I'll have my cavalry from this side. Where are you guys? There you are. I'm going to have them set up right here. So if they do come out, I can give them a rear charge. That'll work quite nicely. And, for all good fun... Darn it, that was my instant messenger that you hear beeping, which is a shame. While I'm recording, I forgot to turn it off. But I don't want to stop the game, so hopefully that wasn't too annoying or surprising for you. I'll make sure not to do that again in the future. Actually, there's no reason to run these guys. I'll have some infantry protection right there. Oh, that fits quite nicely. Well, not really. They're kind of jammed up Jeff Major style, but that's okay. Alright. Alright, let's just speed things up. Oh, who did I kill, by the way? What was his name? What was the name of the man I killed? Cut Red. Well, he was cut down. Alright. Ooh, that's right. I do not want these guys to fire at will until they all get into place. Actually, there's no point putting them on skirmish either. Get everyone into place. Ooh, I'll remember to do the same thing for these guys. Oh, they're already in on fire. I will. That's right. I took them off. Excellent. Absolutely excellent. Oh, where's William? I think I'm going to have him keep an eye on things right here. That seems like a safe distance. While the rest of my cavalry, one will stick with him. The other two will move over to this flank. Perfect! Okay, I think we're almost ready. Yes, we almost are. We just have to wait for these guys to get into play, so let's just speed it up again. Make sure they have range. Yes. Yes, perfect. Alright, guys. Come on. There we go. Alright, let loose. Let's watch this. Watch this happen. Oh, this is anticlimactic. Doesn't look like I have a decent line of sight. That's a shame. Alright, stop letting loose. There's no point. I guess you actually have to see your target. You know. Go figure. Okay, so then you guys... let's have two guys here. And one guy, go all sneaky sneaky over here. Okay, I won't record this. I will get back to you once everyone's all set again. Oops. My guys got a little too close there. They got hit by some javelin fire. Ooh, quite a bit of it too. Okay, but these guys are all set. So let's distract, help the other guys out by letting loose. Put them here. There we go. Oh, it's raining. That's a shame. There we go, that's better. Let's move my cavalry up a little bit more. Are they coming for me? Looks like it. Perfect. But my archers then? Yep, let's get ready to charge with the rest of my men. Okay, we're gonna have my archers stop firing. Backspace, there we go. And let's charge with the cavalry that I just mentioned. There we go. And they broke, just like that. Perfect. So we're going to just end that battle. So only had 22 losses, most of them being those archers, I think. Yeah, Breton archers, a few horsemen, a few other archers, but it worked out quite nicely. All right, I'll see you back at the campaign map. There we go, a painless victory, and we're going to lay them to waste. We're going to establish a... yeah, they're mostly down for the local law, so we're going to establish some local law. And, even at a low tax rate, I don't think I can actually move my army out of there without someone, you know, blowing a gasket. Oh, I can! No, never mind. I just moved one unit. Of course it's fine with only one unit. Yeah, no, they're not very happy. I would like to keep on going, though, so I wonder... I wonder if I can send anything over there. How about my cavalry reinforcements? Can I take these guys out with them, no freaking out? So far I can. That's good. Okay, now what are you at? 30%. We're going to need at least a few more units, though. You know what? We're going to lower the tax rate in Bedenford. Throw over these guys. So close. But actually, next turn, the public order will be much better, so I think that's all that's needed. Let's keep this wonderful army going. Oh, these guys are still doing nothing, too. Alright, well, we'll stick you with there as well. Oh yeah, by next turn, I'll be golden. Alright, so let's keep them going. I believe I was going to go around this way, so now they're going to head up to... Helmham, with a port. Fantastic. Good stuff. Looks like they have actual walls, too.